Hi guys, in today's video I'm going to review this kitchen weighing scale which is from Hasle. So I think that's one of the coolest looking weighing scale you can find in the market. I bought that for around 1400 rupees or so, and most of the weighing scale are costing around 1000 rupees, but because it has the ability to sync or show the weight of your food in your mobile app, that's why I bought this. And another feature which offers by this is the ability to sync it with Fitbit. So as you know, like I have been using Fitbit a lot, so I want everything like to be synced with Fitbit. So I always find compatible devices, so I bought that just to test that, like whether it will be a good thing or not. So inside this box you will find one manual, and yes, one manual which shows how to use it with the mobile. So I will show it later. And then the device, so this is the device you will get. So now you can see that's how cool looking device it is. And I one of the things which I like about this is its screen. So if I turn it on, you can see how cool it looks. So you can see it's damn good looking device out there. So one of the only thing which I don't like about this device is it's draining a lot of battery. So I'm using rechargeable batteries, and still it's draining really fast. And I think after 11 to 12 measurements and with the standby time for 20 days, I need to change the battery. So most of the time when I like try to put something to measurement, there is no battery left in it. So that thing I don't like at all. They should have show something like battery capacity thing in this LCD, but they didn't do that. So you never know that whether battery is down or your device stopped working automatically. So another thing which you need to make sure that, or any for any other digital measuring device, is you need to put them on a flat surface. So even if you try to put them in in a different level surface, so it will not going to show you accurate results. So do mind that. And other than that, I think it's very good device, and its measurement looks really nice. And it has the ability, like it has a tear function. So if you put any weight on it and then turn it on, it will automatically detect and minus that, subtracted that weight from it, and it will show it as a zero. So I kind of like that as well. And another thing is like how they have built the logic with the app is, what you need to do is like if you want to log a apple and you don't know how many grams that apple is, so what you can do is you can go to the app, choose food as an apple, and then put that apple on this device. So it will show you the actual weight of that apple, and it will show it in your app as well. So when it will show like 100 grams, then you can add to the log. So 100 gram apple will be logged into your app. So it looks cool while listening it, but it is not practical. So you can't just keep weighing everything on this weighing scale and then try to eat it. But many things, like if you are like into eating seeds, or like other if you take protein powders or so you can use that device to like calculate how many grams in that particular scoop is there, because it will also like nugget the water in the bottle, and then when you put scoop on it, it will going to give you actual measurement of that powder. So I have been using that for, and I think it's pretty accurate, and most of the time I kind of like it. And I will show you how app is working in my next section. So guys, let's see how we can use this device with phone. So there is a app called AI Fresh which you need to download, and it will automatically get synced. So when this app is opened, what you need to do is you need to choose food first. So let's just choose randomly, maybe breakfast types, cereal ready. So it will show you all the things, the contents of it. The cool thing about this app is it contains lots of stuffs like zinc, magnesium, niacin, cholesterol, vitamin E, vitamin C, which most of the apps are lacking. So it has lots of nutrition facts, but the database is very less, so you need to create your own. So yes, it is also provide you ability to create new food. But when you choose a food, you need to click on this right icon. So now your food is chosen. So you need to put that on your weighing scale. So I have opened it and I will put remote for a reference. And now it is showing 51. So as you can see, it is showing 51. It is also showing inside your app. When I take it out, put away from this weighing scale, it will show zero. So when I put it back again, so it will show 49 something. So there is a slight variation because of this bat also. So 1 to 2 grams, it will not going to be that accurate. So you need to bear with me for that. So when you have chosen the food, then you need to click on add plate. So when you do that, it will going to lock that particular cereal with that measurement into your diary. So now it is added. So let me just focus it, and you can see it gets added. It has a 180 kilogram calories. And that's it. I think it will not going to show you nutrition facts again, which other mobile apps are doing that. But as you can see, it is showing just fine, and it has other options as well, like nutrition analysis. So here it will show you how many calories you have taken and what is the current status, and you can also add the upper limit to it so that it can be compared like that only. And this is the graph. So it's a good app, but it lacks some functionality, it is not showing any nutrition fact about this particular product which I have added it. So for that I will not going to like it. And now I will show you that auto tear function. So you put that remote on it, and when you click on, so it will automatically tear all the weight it has, and you can just start putting above it. So if you go to the app, it will show 33 gram again, and it will take last input as your selected input. So do mind that. But that is how the app can be used, and use it for plate. It is also have a ability to sync with Fitbit, but it takes time. It is not that it is not that fast in syncing. So I might it might get updated after 5 to 10 minutes, I think. Let me just go to the Fitbit app and see whether it gets synced or not. So let's just go to start logging your food, and as you can see, it's showing zero calories, but after syncing it will show 180 something here. So I have checked it, it worked, but it is quite slow, so can't say anything about it. But it's good to know that many companies are doing that experiment to sync it with third party tools. And I will love it if they I would have loved it if they give us some APIs to use it on our custom websites or custom softwares. But for now it is the only option available here using the AI Fresh. So I think you get the idea of how to use this using AI Fresh. And if you have any comment regarding this device, because I have owned it, I can find it for you if you are looking for something similar. And if this video of any help for you guys, please like and subscribe so that I can get motivated and create more new videos. So thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.